Alaska is home to the majority of the glaciers in the United States. Roughly 25% are within Alaska's national parks. Often, they're an important part of any visitor's experience. Today, the foot of the Kennecott Glacier in Alaska's Wrangell-St. Elias National Park lies hidden beneath miles of dirt and rock called glacial till. But the Kennecott, like many glaciers, has changed dramatically in the past 50 years. The National Park Service has seen broad public interest in changing glacier landscape. They asked geologist Mike Loso of Alaska Pacific University and a team of University of Alaska scientists to document the status and extent of glaciers in 9 of Alaska's parks to better understand the processes behind their widespread retreat.
I'm Mike Loso. I'm an associate professor at Alaska Pacific University, where I teach geology, earth sciences, glaciology. And I got involved in the Status and Trends Project at the beginning, along with some co-investigators up at University of Alaska Fairbanks, Anthony Arendt and Chris Larson. And the three of us, along with a bunch of people who worked on it and helped, were the principal investigators on that project. And it's nearing completion. We've been working on it for a few years. The project really had two main parts, which is when they're looked at in map view, have these glaciers grown or shrank? How has their footprint changed? We did that piece of it for two different time steps for the period of time in which the glaciers usually were first mapped, which was by the U.S. Geological Survey, and those are the maps that the public gets, the topographic maps. And then we did it again for the most recent satellite imagery that we could get hold of for that given glacier. So again, it varied a bit, but that was usually in the 2000s sometime. So about 50 years of change for an average glacier. That was one piece. The second piece was looking at volume change. And volume change is harder to get because a map doesn't really show you that. For that, the most common approach and the one that we used for this project primarily is laser altimetry, and using that data that shows the elevation of the glacier surface over time, we can use that information to infer the change in thickness of the ice, which when you couple that with the change in area, then you have the change in volume. And that measurement is harder to get than change in area, which you get just from the maps and the satellite images. And it's also the more important measurement for a lot of the consequences of glacier change, like sea level rise and changes in the runoff in rivers and effects on fish habitat and everything. It's really change in volume that we want. Wrangell-St. Elias, to me and to a lot of people, really is about the glaciers. There's no other place that has the kind of ice that we do. And when you talk about taking that away, watching those glaciers shrink, it sort of strikes, I think, at what for some people is the heart of what this park is about. For a lot of people, the outcome of our Status and Trends project is sort of obvious. The glaciers in Alaska are shrinking, and we managed to put some numbers on that. We managed to document how ubiquitous it is, how rare it is for a glacier to be advancing or growing right now. But I think what maybe is striking even for folks who are familiar with the changes in the glaciers here and you know are concerned about the fact that one of the many effects of a changing climate is shrinkage of these pretty neat features in our world, is the scope of it, that there's so much ice in Alaska that when all those glaciers shrink a little, not to mention a lot, it adds up to some really big changes. And I would like to see people cognizant of the magnitude of the changes that are occurring in the state already. I think there's a real common tendency to sort of, even people who worry about climate change worry about 2050 or 2100, you know, what's gonna happen? And I think a big part of the message here is it's happening.
The National Park Service will continue to monitor changes in Kennecott and other park glaciers over time. But changes to major glaciers like the Kennecott will continue to transform Alaska's landscape, ecosystems, and the park visitor experience. And remind us that our environment and wild places are complex, dynamic, and are vulnerable to climate change.